If you're looking for a go anywhere, do anything RC adventure, you're gonna love this 1/12 scale continuous track vehicle that's ready to be put to the test or customized to fulfill the looks of your personal tank track vehicle. Today, we're checking out the Kyosho Trail King. The Trail King is a ready-set vehicle from Kyosho that comes pre-assembled right out of the box with a painted body, a 2200 mAh 6-cell NIM battery pack, a USB-style NIM battery charger, and a dual-stick transmitter. Everything you need for the Trail King is included except for AA batteries for that transmitter. But be warned, charging that 6-cell NIM battery pack with the included USB battery charger will take 10 to 11 hours to fully charge. So having a proper quick charge battery charger is a pretty good idea. But once you get the battery pack fully charged, this track equipped all season vehicle is ready to tackle the terrain and travel through surfaces normal vehicles may struggle in or even get stuck. And that's where the continuous tracks on the left and right side of this really shine. For different people, continuous tracks represent different things. It could be military tanks, monster trucks with tracks, or maybe even tractors for farming or construction use. Whatever the case, tracks are used in these situations because they have a serious advantage in certain terrain conditions because the tracks distribute the weight of the entire vehicle throughout the entire track rather than all of the weight being put on just a few tires. Because of this, tracks are much less likely to sink and get stuck in soft terrain like sand, snow, mud, soft dirt, swamplands, whatever the case. Continuous tracks are king in certain applications, and that's where the Trail King comes in. And like the name implies, it's meant to be a go anywhere, do anything vehicle. And it looks the part too. For the styling, the Trail King has this all season adventurous look to it. The body cab kind of has a Unimog-esque style with the front bumper featuring two working white LEDs with a hard plastic side mirrors and windshield wipers, and then decal styling applied throughout. Now looking through the tinted window decals, the inside of the cab features a bench seat, a dash, and a steering wheel. You can probably even add a driving figure inside if you wanted to. Now back outside, in the back, you'll find a truck bed made from plastic walls attached to the Lexan base, and with that cool bed decal. Below the bed, there is an on-off rocker power switch to turn on and off the vehicle, with two more working lights featuring red LEDs. These LEDs, as well as the front ones, turn on and off with the vehicle. Now removing the bed is really easy. There's just two body clips in the bed that you remove. Now you simply just pop those up, swing up the rear a little, and pull back. You'll notice the front of the body is secured down with two plastic posts that go into body holes. So you'll need to pay attention to that when reinstalling the body. But now with the chassis of the Trail King exposed, you can see just how simplistic this chassis design is. It's kind of boxy, but it's all open, and it's really easy to access everything for your repairs or any maintenance. Up front are two 370 sized motors, one to power each side, with a simple gearbox set up for each side independently. In the center of the chassis is the receiver box with an attached lid. Just behind that is a single Velcro strap to secure the battery, and then a T-style connector for the battery. Now open up the receiver box and it looks like a lot of wiring, but it's all pretty dang simple with two speed controllers and then the LED wiring all connected into the receiver. Now, since there's no steering servo in this vehicle to steer like you would in a normal vehicle, you use the tracks to steer like you would expect. So with the dual stick transmitter, the left stick controls the left track and the right stick controls the right track. To go forward, push both sticks up. To go backward, push them back down. To turn, just push one stick. It sounds really simple in talking about it, but in use, there is a little bit of a learning curve. But it's really not difficult at all, and after a little bit of use, you really do get a handle on how to control the tracks. Now, speaking of the tracks, they are made from a plastic material, but they are continuous wrapping around 5 plastic wheels. The front wheel is our drive wheel connecting to its respective gearbox via a chain on each side. The remaining 4 wheels complete the track, and each one features suspension travel to better grapple the terrain. The track tension is also adjustable if you need it. There are just 2 screws to loosen, and then this axle can slide back and forth a little to adjust how tight you want the tracks. Out of the box, our axle did need to be adjusted a little bit to get the left and right side track tension just right, but it was really easy to do. The plastic tracks can also be taken apart since it's just a solid strip. Well, it's actually 2 strips that have been fastened end to end with really tiny little Phillips screws. And you'll find Phillips screws are used throughout the Trail King. Now, as an option part, Kyosho offers their heavy duty metal tracks, and they're awesome. Now, they're not a necessity for the vehicle per se, it'll operate just fine, but if you're really serious and you like tracks, then you kind of need them. Internally, on those heavy-duty tracks, they're rubber, and then all the treads are metal, so they're gonna be heavier, they're gonna last longer, and they're just gonna provide a better bite into the surface you're driving on. Not to mention, they just look way better than these plastic tracks. Kyosho also offers a lot of other option parts that are intended for their Blizzard, which is their other continuous track vehicle. All of those option parts are compatible on the Trail King. Both the Blizzard and the Trail King are essentially the same vehicle, minus the plow on the Blizzard, the body, and the overall styling. Now, one upgrade that is highly recommended is going to be the metal pinion gear, because the pinion gears included on the Trail King are some sort of plastic composite, which over time are not going to last long. They'll strip out, unlike the metal ones. But other than that, you don't need option parts to make this thing unique. The very first time I saw the Trail King, my very first thought was to take the body from the Kyosho Mad Van and to plop it on here. Now, as you can see, the Mad Van body is like the perfect wheelbase. It's the perfect width. It fits over the stock body really well. All I would do is I would take out that stock body, take some clear Lexan panels, spray them black, put them under here underneath the wheel wells, and then I might trim this front bumper a little bit so that factory bumper with those working lights sticks through, add some custom long body posts, or maybe even just some Velcro on the side to secure the body. And man, this thing would look awesome. Look at that. That's so cool. And that's really what this Trail King is all about, being unique and one of a kind. In the hobby grade world of RC, there really aren't that many tracked vehicles other than that Blizzard we talked about earlier. They're kind of rare and novel, but they really do stand out in the RC crowd. And that's what makes them great for someone who's like an RC collector, somebody who's maybe just looking for a really unique RC experience, or if you just need a change of pace, driving something different from all the other regular RC cars. The speed of the Trail King is just probably walking pace. It's not super fast, but it is super maneuverable. You can turn it on a dime, do 180s if you need to at any time. And if you like tank tracks, what's not to love? Now, when I was a little kid, the most memorable toy grade RC that I ever had was the Nico Landshark. And I can still remember to this day how it felt going out and driving that thing, and it just felt unstoppable. Now, going out with the Trail King felt the same way, but better, because this thing is a proper hobby grade RC that you can upgrade and customize to be however you want. Hence the Mad Van Trail King. I seriously like this though. It's cool. Now, the only downside to the Trail King that we could find is that Kyosho doesn't mention LiPo use at all. It's not in the manual, it's not on their product page. Now, I know people are using 2-cell LiPos with these Kyosho platforms, which tells me if Kyosho isn't mentioning it, then the ESCs included in here probably don't have a LiPo voltage cutoff, which would then make using a LiPo in here dangerous and not recommended. There are some ways around this. You could just wire in your own low voltage cutoff, but if you don't add a low voltage cutoff, don't use a LiPo in this. Other than that, the Trail King is super cool and really unique to drive, and Kyosho offers it in an orange colored body as well as this blue, and both of those models are $299. $99. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a like if you did. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't. And be sure to leave any questions or comments down below. I'm Brett from A-Main Hobbies. Thanks for watching. Now, I know people have used 2-cell lipos with let's try that again. Now, I know people... Dude, isn't this sick, though? I mean, look at that. Look at that. Sorry.